Welcome to this JMC Week webinar on the JMC Student Intro. It's July 20th, 2022. Glad to have you. My name is Paul Fried. I'm the lead trainer here at JMC. Been at JMC for quite a long time. I love training schools, visiting schools, helping people know how to use JMC efficiently. And I am blessed to have my daughter with me today, Claire Fried. Claire, say hello.
Hello.
Tell us something that you are enjoying about this summer and tell us some of the courses that you're interested in looking forward to this next fall.
Well, this summer I've been taking care of the goats in our farm quite a bit. We recently had 3 baby goats, so they are causing a lot of trouble, but it's very fun. And I'm excited. I'm taking a couple classes that I know so far this fall. Intro to cellular biology, which I'm excited about, and how stories change the world. So cool. 2 unique classes.
And you're going to be a senior this year.
Yes.
Great. And Claire's going to give us a little bit of perspective on just some things that she might find interesting in the JMC student portal. So stay up to, so this is intended for you to be able to give to your students at your school. So students, stay up to date on your classroom performance by having convenient online access to all your coursework. JMC Student provides access so you never need to guess how you're doing your classes. With access to academics, bus information, course registration, lunch purchase history, and more, you can check your progress any time of day, ensuring you always have the information you need to succeed. So if you have any questions, you can wait till the Q&A. I've got Q&As throughout this. If you got a question, go ahead and chat it into us and we will answer it when we get to those Q&A slides. So first we're talking about exploring academics. This is the biggest part of the JMC student portal. A comprehensive view of your academic life can help you take ownership of your preparation for the future. The attendance report, report card, midterm report card, progress reports, schedule, transcripts, and lesson plan menu tree items in JMC Student allow you and your family to view all information related to your coursework from the convenience of a web browser. View the same reports your teacher sees in their gradebook so you can stay on top of your attendance and coursework. So now we're just going to take a brief live look because this is just meant to be a brief introduction to the JMC student portal so that students can know what's available to them. So I'm logged into the JMC student online portal here. How did I get there? I'm at my school's main page and I clicked on students. Every student will have their own unique username and password to log into JMC on the View Student Data screen. So really briefly, students can come in and see their attendance report, see how many absences and tardies they have. Maybe they're looking for a perfect attendance award. They can see their report card and print out any grades that they have that's listed there as soon as it's posted. Same with the midterm report card as well. Then progress reports. Progress reports is one of the most helpful ones because you see a schedule of all your courses listed. And for any course that you have assignments listed, this is the summer, so I just put assignments in for one of the courses. After the term, there'll be a grade and maybe a percentage or a total number of points there, depending on how your teacher is assessing you. You can click on that term and it shows below daily work, tests, quizzes, and all the information that you would have there as well. In addition, you can see lesson plans if your teacher decides or any of your teachers decide to put lesson plans in. Each course is color-coded. Then you can also see your credit check detail. This allows you to see how many credits you have earned to graduate and how many you need to earn to graduate as well, which can help you with course registration there as well. A couple other things we have, standards and benchmarks report card. This is typically for the lower grade levels, K-5, K-8 maybe. We put it in there just in case you have a standards-based report card in your school, maybe as a 6th, 7th, or 8th grader. You can print an unofficial transcript from your JMC student. This is helpful because sometimes you need a transcript to take to a driver's test, or maybe you need to go to apply for a some type of a scholarship or something like that. So this is not an official transcript. It will print with a watermark across that says unofficial, but you don't have to go to the school to get it. If you're at a place and they say, hey, you got a student's transcript I can look at to see what your grades are? No problem. You can just hop on a computer, print it off, and you'll be good to go as well. And then we've got our test scores. This is where you'll be able to come in and see what the test scores are, only that are entered into the JMC office program by your school counselor. So right now, this person, John, might have taken multiple standardized tests, but the ACT test is the only one that he has in there as well, and also an alternate assessment as well. So all these are available to you. So Claire, now that you've seen this, is there one or two of these you think that would be most helpful for you day to day as a student?
Definitely the progress reports, because those enable you to see all your different quiz test results and the specific details of each of your different assignments and stuff like that. So you don't have to really it's all in one place.
Yeah, gone are the days when I was in school, you'd wait till the end of the term to get your report card to be like, oh, here's how I'm doing. You can log in every day and see how I do on that test, how I do on the quiz, what's my percentage, what do I need to earn to get an A or B or C, or what's coming up or something like that as well. So super helpful there as well. Great. All right. So back to my home screen. And I don't see any questions, I don't think, listed there. Great. So we'll keep on rolling through this brief overview of the JMC Student Portal. Review busing info. So you can share the peace of mind by knowing who is picking you up and dropping you off at the bus stop to and from school every day with the bus menu tree item in JMC Student. The JMC bus module, you have a convenient glance of all your bus information in one location. Available information includes bus number, bus driver name, pickup and drop off times, even print off your own copy to keep you in the front of your binder as well. So this one's really straightforward, but again, it saves you from having to call the school and ask, you know, what your busing information is. Maybe your school is going to put out here before the summer. So it's right here. Just click on bus. And there's your busing information. Claire, who's picking you up?
Mrs. Bus Driver.
What time is she picking you up?
Nice and early at 7:12.
That's right, two of you. And what time are you getting dropped off?
3:22.
That's all there is to it, right? So you can log in, see that information on the fly. So that's helpful for you there as well. I'm going to keep on rolling. If a question comes up, Sherry, you can let me know. Entering course registration. JMC empowers students by giving you access to information regarding your schedule and course registration. Sign up for courses using the course registration menu tree item and view the required courses that have been added to your schedule. Even see how close you are to graduation with the credit check detail menu tree item, which I'll talk about in just a minute. When your schedule is complete, click the teacher schedule menu tree to view your teacher, the class period and room number, and print a copy of your schedule so you know where you're going when that first bell rings. So I talked about those a little bit on the academics part, but there's definitely crossover. When we look at just courses in general, okay, again, I'll start at my home screen here. I can go here to course registration. The purpose of course registration is for you to come in, typically as a high schooler in the spring, but you didn't do it this way, Chris or Claire, did you?
No.
But the school has the ability to make this available online. So they can register you for courses that might be required, like ninth grade, Phi Ed and language arts and history and health and so on and so forth. Those can be scheduled in. And then you can maybe allow as a student, you'll be allowed to come in and say, well, what are you going to take? I'm going to take French as well. And I want to take journalism. Of course, you'll need some guidance from your counselor on what courses to sign up for, but there's great JMC resources that guide counselors through doing that. So this is meant to be a spring time for you to register for courses. It saves you having to fill out a piece of paper. Then again, when you're scheduled in those courses, you can see your student's schedule. So this is when the start of the school year. Here's my schedule. So some schools will actually, instead of sending out a printed copy of their schedule, they'll actually email folks or text or send a voicemail saying, hey, your schedule is available online. You can go see it. This is where you would go to see that information there. And then when it comes to registering for next year as a senior, which Claire was as well, instead of just picking the course you want, you can check that credit check detail again and say, all right, how many math credits are required? How many have I earned? Where am I deficient? What are the electives that I've done? All those things really fit together. And then they flow, of course, to the student transcript again. And I talk about that as well, how helpful that can be for you there. So really great, easy to use features. But again, if you're gonna use that course registration, you'll be instructed to go there by your school counselors with some guidance on what they want you to sign up for. So great, there we go. The next one, and if you have questions, go ahead and type them in, is viewing lunch transactions. Curious about where your lunch money is going? Check out all the lunch menu tree item to view all your meal transactions for the year. Keep tabs on how much money is in your account. View a list of all the purchases you've made and make sure you have enough money for extra dessert. If you're a really meticulous record keeper, you can even export all of your purchases onto a spreadsheet and categorize your purchases as you see fit. So this one, again, very straightforward. You're going to come in here and you're simply going to click on lunch, and that will show all of your breakfast and lunch transactions here. Claire, what did you have for lunch today?
Homemade hamburger helper.
Not bad, right? Absolutely.
Pretty delicious.
Pretty delicious indeed. Why would a student use this? Well, again, if your family's budgeting how much money you have for lunch, you might want to go through and say, hey, here's how much I spent in the last 3 days, or whatever it might be, and see where that money is going. Or if you have lots of siblings and your family says, hey, why are you taking so much of the lunch money? You can say, hey, come here and look, this is what I have. I'm only eating one lunch meal a day or something like that as well. So really helpful. And again, you can export that if you wanted to here. Maybe you've got a health class or something that's requiring you to track what you're eating for lunch. You can export it right here and sort it. So pretty, again, cool and easy to use feature. All right, keeping on rolling. That hamburger helper is making me hungry, Claire. All right. And then register for flex offerings. This one's that is one that, I told Claire that she would not be familiar with, as it's such a brand new and kind of cutting edge innovation we have in JMC. So you and your friends are working on an enrichment project in the shop and are looking for an extra period for finishing touches. JMC's Flex Scheduler is a feature that allows you to select your very own MTSS or RTI offerings that meet your needs as a learner. MTSS means multi-tiered systems of support. RTI means rush to intervention. When your teachers set up offerings and open them up to students, you can sign up to get the help you need right when you need it. View all available flex schedule offerings and see where you are going during your school's MTSS period. So this is a really cool feature, Claire. Actually, I'll show the live look here. Because what schools can do is they can open up a period in a day or maybe a period every day and have these flex schedule offerings where students can say, all right, sixth period of the day, maybe it's just once a week. You can choose the flex offering that you want. It could be algebra help. It can be going to the gym. It can be going on a nature walk, whatever it might be. It might be extra time in the shop, like we're talking about. So teachers or office folks make these times, makes these offerings available. So when you go to flex schedules here, you can come in and you'll default today and say, oh, I've got two things I can choose from. Now, typically a school, Claire, is going to have 10, 20, 30, whatever, it depends on the size of their school. But each teacher is typically going to offer something. So if you have 70 teachers in your school, you're probably going to see 40 to 60 offerings there. But you would just come in here and say, all right, I can do nature exploration or geometry help time. Which one do you want to do, Claire?
Nature exploration.
Absolutely. So you come here and say students selected, and then that puts it in there. So then the teacher can expect to see you in that class at that time. So from 11:30 to 12:30, we call it tiger time here in Lake City. On the 20th, you can come in, they'll be expecting to see you there. So it's a really cool way. And you'd have all the days listed here. You can choose those days as you go. So it's a great way for students to get individualized learning as they move through. So it's a really helpful tool to go through. Kind of cool, Claire?
Yeah.
Absolutely. And I actually talked to schools that have used this, and the schools say that, you know, there's always a concern like, oh, our students going to go where they're supposed to go? Since students get to choose, they want to go to those areas and go to those flex offerings. So it's really helpful there as well. All right, entering student signatures. Schools use things like student handbooks, technology agreements, and conduct contracts to make you aware of rules and proper etiquette. To make sure you acknowledge these agreements, many schools ask for your signatures as a way for you to let them know that you understand the expectations listed in those forms. With JMC, you can review those forms and sign them digitally to avoid an extra trip to the office. Simply use your mouse as a pen to add your signature once a document is uploaded to JMC from the office. So we'll take a live look at this. And this is really helpful here as well, is that you'll come in here and it is under, where are my student signatures here, Claire? Oh my goodness. Let me go back to my home screen and see. Oh, I might have to log into my previous year to do this. Yep, because I didn't have this one set up. So here we go. I was gonna do this at the end, but this is how you log out and log back in. One of the cool things about JMC Student is you actually can come into a previous year to see information. So if you wanna see your progress reports, there we go, or what you ate for lunch or something like that, you can do that in a previous year. So let's go in here, see if I've got them. Maybe I don't have them turned on. Oh. That's all right. So I'll just tell you what it does is it allows you to come in. There'll be one here called student signatures. It's not always turned on for every school. And you just come in, you'll see the form and just add your signature. So if you see the one I've got right here, it looks just like this. Come in here, click the student signature, use that signature, and you're ready to roll forward. So it just saves you time of filling out paper, postage, all those kinds of things that we have there as well. The other thing that we have that's actually brand new in JMC Student as of last year, it's so new I don't even have it listed in the article, is the alert configuration. You can come in as a student and check to receive an email alert if you're absent or if you're tardy. You can also check to receive an email if you're missing or late scores, or you can put a percentage in here for any course and save that. And by saving those items, it will alert you if you fall below that percentage. So Claire, you might think, well, I always know what's going on in my class, but maybe you didn't turn something on time, like we were just talking about, right? Claire just got a call. Oh, you have an overdue book at the library. Well, shoot, I thought it was an overdue. Well, this is a great way to do it. I want to know if I'm have missing or late scores in there. And so that's an easy way to be able to keep up to date on that. And so that's it. That's the JMC student portal, Claire, to show you how to keep up to date. It puts the ownership in your hands. You don't necessarily need to talk to your parents or guardians. You don't need to go to the school office. You can access all this information right from your JMC student portal. Cool. Cool.
Yeah.
All right. Well then, is there any questions, Sherry? I don't think there is. So we'll just keep it rolling here. We're at the end, which is the JMC news and upcoming events. So I'm gonna wait here for just a second and say, make a couple comments if anybody has any questions. If not, then we'll wrap it up. But you know, the JMC student portal, if you're an adult watching this video, you know, you wanna promote it to your student body, right? You wanna make sure to let them know, here is a great way to do this. It actually saves everybody time, right? And they don't have to wait. No student should have to say, oh, I didn't know what my grade was, or I didn't know what scores were missing, or I didn't know, well, you know, what my lunch balance was, or any of those kinds of things. They can find out that information on their own from a school computer. You could do it from a cell phone. They can log in. It's a web-based program. So any computer, any cell phone with web-based access can access these items as we go. All right. I don't see any questions there, so let's just keep rolling. JMC news and upcoming events. So next week, we've got the flex schedule opportunities for MTSS support. So this is meant for office professionals who want to learn about the flex scheduler. That's why I just showed the JMC student. Now we show the office side of it. Then we've got a webinar on getting ready for back to school. That's going to be a vlog where we're going to walk office folks and administrators through just some tips to make sure you're starting the school year effectively in JMC. Then we have advanced usage of the JMC Message Center. The JMC Message Center is how schools communicate with students and families via text, email, and voice message. And there's basic usage of it, and there's advanced usage, and that's what we're going to go over there as well. And then we've got going through attendance form letters, part one, creating and editing attendance forms with the form designer. Super helpful there. It's to generate forms for students based on absences. It can save your school lots of time and money as well. We're looking for 6 passionate part-time client service specialists in Nebraska, Minnesota, Wisconsin. These would typically be folks who've worked at your school as a teacher, administrator, school counselor, tech professional. As a client service specialist, you'll develop meaningful relationships with our users through communication, training, and support. In return, we offer a competitive salary and an opportunity to work remotely. Read the full job posting for further details. To apply, email your resume and a letter of introduction to hr@jmcinc.com with job application in the subject line. Also, we have our summer conference coming up here. We're calling all office users. You can sign up between May 2nd and July 31st. The building that sends the most attendees, Claire, wins a pizza party for their building.
That sounds epic.
That's right, absolutely. So that would be awesome. So make sure you get folks there. And JMC's training team is back at it for a summer full of training. From new administrators to teachers to office folks, we have training just for you. So grab a pal and check out all of our summer training opportunities to ensure you hit the ground running this fall. Sign up for any or all of our conferences today by searching for a summer conference lineup using our in-app help widget. Always somebody there to train you. Another great way to stay up to date on all things JMC is through our social media presence. Follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and LinkedIn at OnlineJMC or our blog listed there. So on behalf of myself and Claire Free and Sherry Phillips, thanks for joining us today and thanks for choosing JMC.